But now, let's talk about Mario 3. This is going to be short because there's not much you can say that already hasn't been said a million times, but I'll put it blunt and simple. This game kicks your ass till diarrhea comes out your dick. The only thing better than playing this game would be to have a magic leprechaun come and bring you beer. There's 8 worlds, each with a different theme. Desert, snow, sky, and my favorite is the one where everything's giant. Each of the worlds has a big map screen where you can select which level you play. At first it's as simple as clearing each level and moving on, but later the paths become more complicated, whether it means going through pipes, breaking through boundaries, or sailing over water. But the actual levels are what it's all about. Slide through a bunch of bad guys, oh, that's so much fun. The two-player game has a perfect balance. It's where you can either work together to complete the game, or just compete for items and race each other to the end. Or you could die deliberately so that the other player will have to play the hard levels. There's card games, puzzle games, and even a bonus stage where you can play the original Mario Bros. Arcade. Again, this offers many possibilities to be an asshole toward the other player. The power-ups are awesome. In the original Mario, there's the mushroom and the fire flower, but now there's the leaf that turns you into a raccoon. You can break blocks with your tail, or if you get a good stretch of land to run, enough to get your P bar up, you can fly for a short period of time. But if you get the P wing, you can fly through the whole level. There's also the P switch that turns blocks into coins. What does P stand for? And why is there so much P in this game? It's not full of shit, it's full of P. But about the power-ups. You also have a frog suit that swims a lot easier, you got a hammer suit which throws hammers, and a tanuki suit that turns into a statue. I don't know what that's about. I mean, I know you use it to protect yourself from enemies, but man, what kind of crack were they smoking? But the really cool thing is that you can save these power-ups and use them whenever you need them. Like before the start of the level, you might think, eh, it's time to break out the frog suit. The enemies in the game are out of control. You got these Goombas hopping around in wind-up boots, then you got an angry sun, Big Bertha, and nuclear waffles. Not to mention, you gotta fight all the Koopa kids and beat Bowser at the end. Alright, going through the pipes. Oh, wait. Oh. Bullshit! What a bunch of fucking bullshit! Come on, you piece of shit! Come on, move your ass! Hey, how do I get this flower right here? I don't know, I'm just gonna try to... Come on! Yeah, alright. This game's tricky-dicky. It's pretty damn hard, too. Then there's this part where the only way to reach the goal is to fly in the air while holding a Koopa shell and break all the blocks. Who would even think to go up there? Especially when you get to the last world, it can get real challenging. This part doesn't fuck around. It's like, you got to the end, you dare to play, welcome to hell. That's what it looks like. All this fire and skulls, it looks like hell. There's sort of like a heart shape around it. Yeah, a heart around hell. Does that mean that this game loves hell? This game worships the devil! Oh my god, of course it does. Why is there so many inverted crosses? What's the H stand for? Hell? How about the part with the tarot cards? The N? Necronomicon? The P must be possession. Or maybe pentagram. Well, of course, the pentagram makes an appearance everywhere. It's no doubt that the 7 sons of Bowser represent the 7 deadly sins. You kneel before Satan on the block, and after 6 seconds you fall through. There's 6 arrows on the possession meter, and to reach the goal, you go in the 6th door. That's 666. Everywhere you look, it's the number of the beast. In The Wizard, the game's introduction is basically the gates of hell opening.
I'm up here, my little beauties.
Shit! Yeah, video Armageddon. The devil watches you through the whole game. The clouds have eyes, the hills have eyes. Yeah, literally, the hills have eyes. Thanks heaven, and we know that there's no need to thank heaven unless there's the presence of hell. There's 8 worlds. In the 8th world, there's 5 spaces you can stand on where giant hands drag you down to your doom. There's 12 tanks you gotta jump on before the goal, and it takes me 12 jumps to get Bowser to fall down the hole. The 8th letter of the alphabet is H, 5 equals E, 12 equals L. What's that spell? Hell! And what's it sound like when you play the game backwards? This game's a product of the fucking devil. And none of the other Mario games are like that, so I don't know why it's only this one, but in conclusion, all I can say is that other than being the total epitome of evil, Super Mario Bros. 3, it's a good game. So good it's a sin.
Your mother.
Oh my.
god, it's a possessed NES.
Your mother sucks cocks in hell.
The fuck did you just say?
I said, your mother sucks cocks in hell.
Go back to hell, you evil motherfucker!
Shove it up your ass, you motherfucking cocksucker!
Power of Christ compels you!
What an excellent fucking day for an exorcism.
Power of Christ compels you! Power of Christ compels you!
Yeah, fuck your mother!
Power of Super Mecha Death Christ compels you!
Fuckers! Fuckers!
Actually, with my mouth wasn't what I did.
Yeah, Super Mecha Death Christ 2000 BC version 4.0 beta, bitch!
Fuckers!
Holy shit!
What's your fucking language? Fuckers! Want some?
I'll tell you all about it.